this perfectly captures, you know, the snapshot of my life. Pagal Patrakar, yeah, that's my pseudonym. That's how I started. In a way, I have done a ghar vapsi. I was a journalist, now I am back to in a media house. Essentially, I am doing journalism, although fake journalism. You know, when you talk about off the beaten path, you know, this is what I did. I mean, I kind of Googled for it. So beautiful images, you know. It looks pretty romantic. Why wouldn't anyone do it, you know? But, you know, the reality could as well be like this. But trust me, I mean, once you take the path, even this could look pretty romantic. Even this could, you know, really inspire you. And actually, this is a picture from a wildlife safari in Tanzania, I guess. So, you know, it might look like somewhere in deep Uttar Pradesh or Bihar, but it's actually romantic. You know, I'll say that let's go a little bit literal. When you have a high-paced highway and everyone is taking, you know, that route, why would go off-beaten path? I mean, why would anyone do that? If we take it very literally, these could be the reasons. Maybe you miss the bus. You don't have any option. You don't have a taxi. You don't have your own car. So you have to go along that path. Maybe because you don't have any option. Well, you were driving and you got really bored. I don't want to do it. Let me do, you know, go this off beaten path. Maybe you were pushed. You know, and suddenly you find that, okay, you know, the highway back there is kind of too far. Now that I'm already here, let me tread this path. This could also be a reason that you actually believe that this is a shortcut. You know, everyone is going through the highway, but they are not really, they are going to take a lot of time. Let me take the shortcut. Or you never had a destination to go. You know, it was always about enjoying your journey. It was always about let me figure out what this path is about. I'm just going to walk on it and enjoy it. Now, you know, funnily, almost everything is related to me. And let me tell you how. I miss the bus. You know, I'm not that saffron guy. And unfortunately, you know, if you follow me on Twitter, I'm usually a painted saffron. But I am that guy. I've made arrow. I miss the bus, and this is they all are running to get into IITs. You know, so I come from Bihar, and I grew up in the 80s and 90s. There, obviously, you know, you have to become an engineer or a doctor. I couldn't become an engineer. And engineer also, you have to be in IITs. Nothing less will do. So, you know, I missed the bus. I mean, I couldn't, I was good at maths. Somehow that convinced me and my parents that I can become an engineer, I can get into IIT. Slowly I realized that apart from maths, I also need to study chemistry. And that was, you know, that's where the dream ended. So I missed the bus. I couldn't qualify for IITs, so that's where I started, kind of introspecting that what do I want to do next? I mean, was engineering or IIT, was that always the calling of my life? I mean, is that really what I wanted to do? I mean, everyone was running, I was also running, so maybe I was running because of that reason. Maybe I don't really love math so much. Maybe I don't really love numbers so much. And that was true. It was not, you know, maybe you can say Majboori ka naam Mahatma Gandhi or whatever, but I did realize that actually, you know, numbers were not, I was not really so enamored by numbers as I was with words. My father is a literature professor in literature, and we grew with all those English classics in our home, and I always, I had this strange, I wanted that my name should be there on a book. So I wanted to be a writer somehow. And when all this IIT business was out of my way, when I knew that, okay, this is not going to happen, I thought, why not try my hand at writing? Fortunately, my parents were supportive. They said that, okay, whatever you feel like, you can go ahead and do it. You can, if you think you want to be a writer, figure out how you can become a writer. So I started looking for how exactly I can become a writer. And I saw that, okay, most of these English novelists, be it Mark Twain or even the, someone as recent as Gabriel Garcia or anyone, all of them were journalists. You know, they were working as a journalist. So I thought, okay, perhaps this is how one becomes a writer. So let me also become a journalist. So even though I was studying maths at my graduation level, I was more interested in listening to ghazals. I was more interested in writing, a little bit. I even tried writing a bit of short stories and all that. And I was hardly attending colleges. This was what I was doing. I wanted to be a writer. I wanted to be a journalist. So next thing, that's how I came into the world of journalism. So that was my first call. That's how I got into that off-beaten path. I was pushed into it because I missed the bus. So I got into journalism. So I was going on. Now still that was not that off-beat path really. I soon realized that I got really bored. Okay, this is me. At one point of time, I used to look like this. It's what, 2004 or 2005. So right, because I wanted to be a journalist, I took entrance exam for IIMC, Indian Institute of Mass Comm. This is just a kilometer away from here. I did my journalism from there. Unfortunately, in retrospect, I did radio and television journalism. That's broadcast journalism. I wanted to be a writer, and I was there in a TV doing such things, making story about how a pony loves beer and stuff like that. There was hardly any writing, for God's sake. I think it was more because of glamour and all. I chose broadcast journalism. I should have gone for print journalism, maybe. Although when I see the print writers, I think maybe that wouldn't have helped any better. So I was really bored. I mean, I thought the reason why I was here, that I will enjoy doing it. It was not happening. It was just another job. I mean, the second one, I was really bored. So, and apart from that, as I was talking earlier to some guys who were talking to me, that this question, where do you see yourself 5 years from now, I was not able to see anywhere. So I was also scared. So I thought that, okay, I'll go for higher studies. And this is where I landed. 2.5 years in journalism, I decided that, okay, I have to take a break. This was not really that off beaten track that I wanted. I took CAT, was fortunate. I got into IIM Ahmedabad. And there, the third thing that I told you, the push happened. The first push happened in the wrong direction. Again, I got into rat race. Again, I thought I also want to be an investment banker in London earning millions. I realized that I didn't have skills nor the appetite to become an investment banker. So the first push happened in the wrong direction, but the second push happened in the right direction. And that push was given by one of the professors. His name is Dr. Sunil Handa. I attended a guest lecture by him, and he brainwashed me. And he brainwashed one of my dorm mates also, that's the hostel mate. And we also decided that no, we want to do something of our own. That's where we start. I got attracted to web entrepreneurship. In fact, there is Dr. Handa, Sunil Handa, Professor Handa, he is so pro in brainwashing you that actually we had a business plan of setting up an ethanol factory in Bihar. And we went to Professor Handa. I am dead sure that he must be laughing inside. But what did he do? Next day, he gave his own, a Jeep or a big SUV, and me and my, dorm mate, we hopped onto that, and we went to some Anand or somewhere in Gujarat and saw those sugar mills, because ethanol is also a byproduct of sugar. So he said that go and study how sugar, these things happens. Now, and then on speakerphone, he made us talk to the founder and managing director of Renuka Sugar Mills. And we were like, oh, is it happening? We are really going to set up ethanol industry. And not only that, we actually made a presentation to then Bihar Chief Minister Nitish Kumar that we want to set up an ethanol factory in your, in your state. Now, soon we realized that obviously this is not going to happen. We don't have any money. We don't have any experience. The only experience that I have about sugar is this. So this was not going to happen. By then we were really brainwashed. We were pretty sure that we can do something of ourselves, of our own, and we were looking for alternatives. What could it be? So web entrepreneurship is what we decided, because this is not a capital intensive thing. I'll say we started with a virtual website, a virtual gaming website called Cricket Stock Exchange. It was 2007 when I was in final semester. We launched this website. It became very popular. Even right now, if you go and search Crick Stock, you will get Google results about us. That's where our first mistake happened, is that we hadn't planned for the worst. We were always flying high. We were always thought that, okay, we at IIM the bar, and we can do this and we can do that. Of course, Professor Handa was there, who was always saying that, okay, you can go for stars and everything. And in 2007, when we did this, the website attracted a lot of attention. We were all over media. But 2007 World Cup, those who follow cricket would know, it was horrible. India and Pakistan kicked out in first round. Bob Woolmer killed. Somebody thought he died. Nobody in media wanted to talk about cricket. So our product died. We hadn't really thought about what to do, what was the plan B. But I was sure that, and that's how this first partnership with my business, my friend also, it's that project got shelved. We ultimately sold off the website. And then this, I was pretty sure that I don't have to go back to, all this corporate life, or I don't want to go and get any job for now. And then something that I wanted to do happened. So somebody called me a Pagal Patrikar. So I decided that, okay, let me take this pseudonym and start writing this fake news thing. Now, in second year itself, I had this idea, although I was trying for a business, an ethanol industry and a crick stock and cricket stock exchange and things like that. Having been a journalist, I always wondered that why can't something like The Onion work in India? I mean, we are a highly diverse society. Every chai ka nukkad you go, people are talking politics. People are so aware about news. We are so plural when compared to a nation like United States. And if news satire can work there, there was no reason why it shouldn't work here. So that's why I thought that it has to work. Somebody has to perhaps give it a serious thought, give it a passionate execution. And that's when I decided that no, I'll do this. And although it happened 1 year after what I had thought, after I went solo with from my partner, and I launched Faking News, and I started writing anonymously because I wanted feedback. I wanted people to tell me how good or how bad I was writing. So initially I would write stuff, I would send it to my friends, even my family members didn't know that I was doing it. And I would say that, okay, somebody is doing it, tell me how it is. And then I'll get the feedback and I would incorporate them. And then this lucky break happened in 2009, 1 year after that when I wrote this story about this boy who has sued Axe because he couldn't attract a girl. Now, because of some strange reason, because the reality is as strange as fiction, in fact, stranger than fiction, it was taken as a true news by international agencies. And for a long time on Google, especially on google.com, if you went and typed Indian man, the autofill options was Indian man sues Lynx. Axe is known as Lynx in the European and American market. So, and that's how it became an urban legend. So slowly, that became my first lucky break. And because of social media also, it started growing. And I was pretty sure that I don't have to get this lucky break off my, I have to make sure that every week, every second week, I get something that is viral. And that's when I started taking it as a profession that I have to carry carry forward in as if it was my day job. The fourth thing I was talking was, do you really go on an offbeat path because of a shortcut? This is wrong. You know, I won't say that I haven't been influenced by this. But yeah, at some point of time, you do think that maybe what I have created will become a multi-million empire and all that, and you will catch up with your friends. But that was for a very short duration, especially during Crick's talk. With faking news, the only thing that was driving me was my love for it, for my passion for it. For an entire year, I earned perhaps fraction of what my batchmates were earning in a month. So, you know, if you are looking for a shortcut, I would say never go the offbeat path, because that would never work. If there was a shortcut, people would have known it. Unless, obviously, that you are really that genius, that you are the only one who suddenly found out that shortcut, go ahead. But it will more often than not, it will not be shortcut, because if it were a shortcut, people would have found it. So I would say the most important thing is that it has to be a journey. It has to be, you know, if you are going the offbeat path, it's the passion that you have to that should drive you. It doesn't have to be shortcut. How you came on this path is obviously it can be because you got bored, you were pushed, you were you missed the bus. But once you are on the path, if you have to keep walking, it's the only the passion that should keep you driving. It should the only be your, you have to enjoy the journey, and it will give you returns. You know, if you are passionate about it, I have worked for like 12 hours, 13 hours in a day. It doesn't sound like work because I'm enjoying it. You know, and but it also gives you return. You might think that, okay, now that it has been acquired by Network 18, that has given me return. No, my biggest return is my wife. She used to follow faking news, and I had a chat widget over there. So this is how, you know, my, and today is my wedding anniversary. So I think that should be good enough, especially for the boys to go on the offbeat path. But yeah, remember, yeah, if you, it is romantic, definitely, but it's also a little bit painful. Ask her when I'm just getting on Twitter, and I'm not getting her attention. So of course, it becomes painful for her, and also sometimes for me also, you can imagine. This is how I would end that. No matter how you end up being over there, it could be one of those reasons. Once you are there, it has to be only passion, nothing else. Thank you.